Hello students, let us start with today's video in continuation with the previous video. In the last video, we print the numbers from 1 to 100, which gives us the remainder 1 when divided by 7. Suppose multiple conditions are there, program to print the numbers from 1 to 100, divisible by, suppose I write here 200. Divisible by, or you can print here 50 to 200. Suppose this range is there. Divisible by 2 and 3, but when divided by 5, gives us the remainder 1. There are three conditions now. The number should be divisible by 2. The number should be divisible by 3. Let us try to print out this. Int I for I is equal to 50, I less than equal to 200, I plus plus. It means the values are from 50 to 200. Printf percentage D, then I. Execute the program. The values are from 50 to 200. You can see the values. All the values are here. Suppose I have to print the values I modulus 2 is equal to 0. Again execute the program. It means now you can filter the values which are divisible by 2 only. 50, 52, 54, 51 is eliminated because it's not divisible by 2. Similarly, all other means there is no odd value, all the even values are there. Now the second condition, if you have to apply second condition, you can apply 2 times ampersand or logical AND. Then I modulus 3 is equal to 0. It means now you can apply two conditions. The number when divided by 2 gives us the remainder 0, and the number when divided by 3 also gives us the remainder 0. Let us execute the program. Now you can filter some more values. 54, 60, 66, these values are there. These numbers are divisible by 2 and 3 both. It means these numbers when divided by 2 gives us the remainder 0. Also when divided by 3 gives us the remainder 0. Now apply the third condition. Third condition is when divided by 5 gives us the remainder 1. Apply this condition. 5 double equal to 1. It means the third condition is divisible by 2, divisible by 3, but when divided by 5 gives us the remainder 1. You can apply multiple conditions in this way. The numbers are 66, 96, 126, 156 and 186. You can check all the values. The number is divisible by 2. Number is divisible by 3, but when divided by 5, it will give us the remainder as 1. Similarly, you can change the condition also. 1 here. Then execute the program. These are the values. It means the number when divided by 2 gives the remainder as 1, but divisible by 3 and number when divided by 5 gives us the remainder as 1. You can change the conditions according to your choice, but our problem is this. When divided by 2 gives us the remainder as 0. When divided by 3 gives us the remainder as 0. When divided by 5 gives us the remainder as 1. You can develop more problems according to your choice. Thanks for watching my video.